Asian continent as Jun Ji-hee, who's done it before. Here we go. I bring that up because while Europe is an incredibly strong continent, it is a distant second to Asia in table tennis. And within Asia, China just levels above the rest of the world. So a good start here on the receive. Chun Meng not bothered by the serves of her opponent, Jun Ji-hee.
Let to love. Three, love.
Everything going perfect for Big Dream so far. Now, one thing I will say, if you're looking for inspiration stories, I mentioned that 29 for Team China is old. It's just straight up old for the women's team. I mean, Li Xiaoxia won an Olympic medal and retired at 28 years old.
Love, five.
Ding Ning, not too much after that. Recent dip in the world rankings to world number 4. Despite those two defeats, you have to wonder, will Chun Meng quickly come back? Well, right now she's leaving no question as to what she can bring on the table. Very satisfied Ma Lin there on the coach's bench. Shovel serve, perfect read of the top and side spin there from Chun Meng. Just goes with the spin where the ball would naturally carry. Thinking back to the 11-0 win, still a ways to go. It used to be a tradition. We would call it a courtesy point. It starts to sound like something of the past.
When I was a child, a nickel would get you a movie and a hot dog.
But the first point here, it was no mercy. Good placement here from Jun Ji-hee into that crossover. Nice change of pace as well. Yeah, Liu Shiwen, when she became world champion in 2019, in two matches, the semifinals and the finals, if I remember correctly, no mercy, 11-0.
1-8.
But a nice flick here, the brushing shot to that wide forehand. Left-handed players often get a little bit comfortable turning that backhand corner to play forehands, which leaves them vulnerable on the wide forehand. Well-exploited opportunity by Chun Meng. Good touch here from Jun Ji-hee, keeping it just low enough inside the table to deter that forehand flick. First time I can recall seeing Chun Meng with her hair fully tied up. Usually it's just a ponytail. Wonder what the change was inspired or why. Maybe a little bit more focus. But that one was like a laser down the line, untouched the parallel backhand. And now 8 game points for the world number 4, the defending Olympic champion, Chun Meng. One saved here with a nice parallel backhand, Jun Ji-hee. One of the things about Jun Ji-hee for me that's made her quite strong in the last several years of table tennis is her speed. Her timing. She's good at giving back what comes in. But here it's a long push to the backhand side, and Chun Meng 1-0 now. See how she does here in game 2.
One love.
Just about to say as clean as can be, but acknowledging some fortune there. I've been crossing the net. I will say that Chun Meng seemed to be in good spirits. Run into her on a few occasions so far this week.
Love, two.
Not that she's ever in a bad mood. Not that I've seen. Simply that She seems relaxed. She seems at ease. There seems to be a freeness about her here right now.
Love three.
Just amazing how quickly she can play a parallel, change it up, go cross court if she wants. Chun Meng, forehand flick. Body, if I were to guess, even watching the replay, I would have been expecting that cross court. Now this position is not going to be one that favors anyone at this level to be that far behind the table. Excellent start here. Nice after motion to follow the serve. Jun Ji-hee, right at the point of contact, pulls the racket back and moves the racket around in the opposite direction. How do you play with this? Fast long serve to the backhand and not letting Jun Ji-hee come up for air. Wow, years and years, over a decade of hard work at the professional level already to have the fan club she has, Chun Meng.
1-5.
First towel break, pretty similar proportions here in terms of the sharing of the scoreboard. Lee Hyun in the corner for Jun Ji-hee. There's lots of work to do. You can see the Chinese setup there from the blade and the racket, meaning the rubber. So the racket itself is covered in Chinese rubber.
1-6.
For those of you that are into equipment, first of all, playing with a professional racket changes everything you thought you knew about table tennis. You can spin the ball and make it hook and curve. It takes a little time to learn to control, but it takes the roof off in terms of limitations. But this Chinese rubber is a little bit tackier. Oh, burning backhand, just blistering past. What that tackiness can do is it can make the ball with the hard sponge underneath barely bounce in the short game, but when you come in with a lot of racket speed, it grips the ball even more, so you can generate more spin as opposed to speed.
8-1.
You could feel that was almost like throwing in the flag in this point. Jun Ji-hee immediately put on the defense. And then as soon as it comes up a little bit higher, just has to try to punch it back. Sort of a Hail Mary, do whatever I can.
1-9.
So edging near this finish line, Chun Meng not allowing much on the other side right now. That's what she needs to do to get through it. She's been vulnerable recently. Back edge of the table, and now 9 game points for Chun Meng. One game point saved here from Jun Ji-hee. It's interesting to think about within the Chinese national team, who is vulnerable, who is slightly more vulnerable at the top of the food chain.
11-2.
It's Jun Ji-hee to start off game 3, down 0-2, serves on her side. Even behind the table, Chun Meng can counter loop for days. Beautiful forehand flick, but well anticipated and a quick move. Jun Ji-hee is able to deflect the ball, bring it right back. Classic pattern there, short to the forehand, bring the opponent in, then go deep to the backhand, testing the footwork really.
11-1.
Just so fast. Chun Meng, after that injury, came back with more muscle. She was stronger, she was bigger, but it was muscle, and it was in the right places to make sure that she was going to prevent injury As Ma Long has said, the only thing he fears is injury. For a professional athlete, that can be the end of your career.
Coming on the table, he's fullback.
2-1.
Sounded like the warning was that the toss was from inside the table. The rules are that you must toss the ball above and behind the baseline of the table, and you must contact it also above and behind the baseline of the table. Nothing about how wide or how far behind. Typically, it wouldn't be to your advantage to serve from that far behind the table, although at the Finnish national championships recently in the semifinals, a few serves were done from about 2 meters behind the table, which was fascinating to watch, especially because they were effective.
3-2.
So Jun Ji-hee up by one here. Bit of hope.
3-0.
Even the quality of the rallies, it just feels like Jun Ji-hee's taking her chances, and she has to. If you're the underdog, if you're the expected loser of a battle, you come in knowing that you can't play comfortably. You have to do something different and take your chances. Right to the corner. That vulnerable wide forehand corner of Jun Ji-hee. And fired up here, Chun Meng sees a different player. Serve and the follow-up, both on the parallel. As smooth as can be with that backhand. To be as strong as Chun Meng is, takes a lot of muscle, obviously, a lot of work to build that strength and muscle, but there's a fine balance of how tightly you grip the racket as opposed to when you contact the ball, how loose to get the racket speed you need.
3-6.
And you can see just the perfect balance right now from Chun Meng. Good to see all these faces once again. Thank you, China. Smiles all around. Been some time, long awaited by all. 3-6 here. Best point we've seen in some time from Jun Ji-hee on top of everything in the counter. Again, the quality of the rallies. She's not playing afraid, that's for sure. Short strokes paying off. Jun Ji-hee on top of the bounce with the backhand, very efficient. Oh, as wide as can be. One step behind the table. Jun Ji-hee is not tall, I'll tell you that. So the wingspan leaves a little bit of room for coverage there. A little bit of room to be desired.
Let 7-4.
Chun Meng makes it look so easy to just turn the racket back and pop it up to yourself and catch it. Tough to appreciate sometimes how incredibly controlled the players are with these rackets.
5-7.
And just to add to that, they're constantly trying to make it as uncomfortable as possible for their opponents. So it's Jun Ji-hee here with a nice clean opening from the baseline. Just 2 points separate them now. Jun Ji-hee with some big serves to come. Remember, Jun Ji-hee must win this game and every game for the rest of the match.
To continue
in this event, Chun Meng has her options, but would choose to finish here. Just turns back quickly for a word from Ma Lin. Good pressure into the middle. Catches Jun Ji-hee right on the elbow between that forehand and backhand. 3 points away from moving on through. It was the round of 16 where Bernadette Such beat Chun Meng, the last champions in Macau, end of 2022. Oh, wow. Chun Meng really almost spilling out there to reach that forehand. Jun Ji-hee right there for the next ball that comes back. One to the middle, inside out forehand. Chun Meng realizes, yeah, it's just too good. Her last appearance, Chun Meng, the Singapore smash. It was the round of 32 that Ellie Samara got the best of her. Round of 32 here, Chun Meng looking to improve her recent result in Singapore. And a fast, tight serve. It's an unusual combination. When you think about in table tennis as opposed to, say, tennis, where you're not hitting, in tennis you're hitting the ball straight down at your opponent's side of the court. In table tennis you have to hit your side first, so how fast can a serve be, especially if it's not a long serve? But the pros find ways to do it, keeping it low to the net, really well calculated. In the middle here, shovel serve to come. Or so it appeared, but the pendulum comes out and Chun Meng is right there with the answers. 3 match points for Big Dream Da Meng, Chun Meng. Again, the round of 32 is where we are now, and it's where she exited, where she got off the train last time in Singapore. Chun Meng, 1 point away. And she does it. Chun Meng one-upping her performance in Singapore. Moves on to the round of 16.